Removing spyware is such fun, isn't it? I was asked to fix this laptop, which is so cheap it doesn't even have a brand name. It just says notebook. And on the bottom there's some Chinese writing. And it was loaded with fake antivirus, fake anti-spyware software, so just going through and trying to get rid of it. The first one I was able to remove, but then it wouldn't let me run any programs because the spyware changed the registry to redirect the Windows system calls to itself. So when you remove the spyware, then suddenly things don't work in Windows. But luckily I was able to find a file on the web that changes the registry back to its correct settings, so now I can actually run programs. Now I'm just going through and removing all the other junk. This thing had at least 3 toolbars in Internet Explorer. And there's other suspicious things in here like coupon, amazing, e-games toolbar, film fanatic toolbar. It has Google Chrome at least, that's not too bad. Google toolbar for Internet Explorer. Inbox toolbar, IncrediMail toolbar. So lots of stuff to remove and fix. This is a Pentium M designed for Windows XP, has Home Edition installed. Graphics by ATI, but no brand name. Some kind of buttons on the front there. And black tape covering a corner where it probably got dropped and the plastic is all cracked. This side has an SD card slot and a PC card slot. This side has a DVD RW drive and some USB ports. And on the back, it has VGA, S-Video, Ethernet, modem, FireWire, and a cooling vent. So, not too bad, just totally generic, no brand name. It actually claims to support Sony memory stick as well as SD cards and multimedia cards. Here's the BIOS setup screen. It says Inside Software SCU. Processor is Pentium M, 1.6 GHz. 512 megs of RAM. I thought it would have more than that, but it's only running Windows XP, so that's not too terribly bad. And there is absolutely no options here, even advanced. Only option is USB support and boot sequence. So there's like no advanced options whatsoever in the BIOS setup. They couldn't even use a real BIOS brand like Phoenix or AMI or Award. They went with some cheapo no-name brand. Well, I was able to remove all of the spyware and toolbars and crap that was listed in the control panel programs list, but I still need to put a real malware scanner program on it and make sure it's totally clean before I give it back to its owner. But considering the time, I think I'm going to save that for another day. But I just wanted to show the size comparison. It says notebook, but compare that to my MacBook. It's definitely not notebook sized. It's definitely a lot larger than that. And I'll show you what's on the bottom. There's the bottom. You get access doors for the battery, the hard drive, and the RAM. And there's the product key for Windows XP Home Edition. And this information thing here, I don't know what brand name that is, but clearly it's not in English. Model DL75. And that's really the only identification that you can read on here if you don't read Chinese. Claims to have US patent, but considering that it's all Chinese, I kind of doubt that's legitimate. as well as all these certifications. So, some kind of no-name Chinese laptop. But, hey, it still works, so give it that much credit. There's the little CPU fan on the bottom. It's the next day, and there's still more work to do on this laptop. I ran a malware byte scan, and it found 15 objects to remove. So there was even more spyware and adware than what was listed in the control panel. And I also discovered that the Windows firewall was turned off and automatic updates were turned off. So I still need to connect this to my internet and have it do it, all its updates, which is probably going to take quite a long time, depending on how long it's been since it last had an update. It had Norton System Works in there, including the antivirus, but it expired in 2011, so it clearly was doing nothing to help protect this computer. So I took that all out, and I'm going to put in some kind of free antivirus that actually works and is current. And this is the first time that defrag is telling me that I should defragment an NTFS drive, because normally NTFS is a lot more resistant to fragmentation than FAT32. It's a 60 gig hard drive and has about 40 gigs free, so that's still quite a bit of space left. So I'm going to do a defrag there and a couple other things, and finally it'll be ready to go. So this is an example of what happens when you run a Windows PC that's completely unprotected against anything. You know, no firewall, no automatic updates, expired antivirus and all that stuff. You end up with so much adware and spyware that it's just bogging down the whole system. And there's even more problems. When I try to run Google Chrome, look what happens. That certainly doesn't look like Google Chrome on the top there, and it has one of these toolbars on it with all this crap on it. So this is all the stuff I had to remove from Internet Explorer. Looks like it's infecting Google Chrome as well. So I'm just going to uninstall Google Chrome and reinstall it from scratch, because it looks like the owner wasn't even using it anyway. Last used 2011. So get rid of that. It's early in the morning again, and I finally get the Windows updates working, because I think one of the things the spyware did is disable the automatic updates. And every time I would try to get it working, it would just give these error codes. So I finally was able to get it working. I don't even know what worked, honestly. I tried so many different things. And suddenly I just saw this little icon pop up out of nowhere. So apparently something I did worked, because the updates are now working, finally.